Thank you very much, Mr. Lekam. Thank you very much for the presentation. What I will speak about is about the role of European reference networks in the newborn screening. We have heard already that newborn screening is an extremely important public health program, which is aimed to identify newborns affected by rare diseases in the presymptomatic way. This has been done in the 60s, especially in the inherited metabolic disorders. And the MetaBRN, the metabolic ERN, is indeed very much interested in this discipline. The newborn screening is performed in different manners, and we heard about in the different member states and the national health systems. And the newborn screening is supposed to be a system and not just a test. So it is a very complex medical act that requires quite a lot of awareness and quite a lot of expertise. The ERNs are for sure one of the major programs of the European Commission. It was starting in 2002 when patients affected by rare diseases went to the Commission to tell to be interested in their diseases. And with time, we had the application of the cross-border directive in 2011, where at Article 12, there is the idea to form the European Reference Network. And in 2014, there was the Commission on the ERN. And then in 2016, the launching of the proposal to create the European Reference Network. The European Reference Network are 24. They are divided in organ and apparatuses. So we have one European Reference Network for lung rather than skeleton, rather than metabolic, neurology, and other apparatuses. The European Reference Network involve at the moment 26 countries, 300 different hospitals in Europe, and more than 900 healthcare units. These are all centers of expertise, excellent center of expertise, approved by the Ministry of Health in different member states, and enrolled in the European Reference Network under a coordinator, and satisfying quite a lot of enrollment criteria to demonstrate to be really at the top level of their disciplines. The structure of the European Reference Network is quite complex, and it is extremely innovative. There are no other programs in the world like this one. It is a patient-centered, and the European Reference Network has the core in the patients together with the clinician, and they are interacting with all the different stakeholders important in the health management, quality of life, and public health policy for the patients affected by rare diseases. They are funded by different hospitals, and they are connected with the health authorities, with laboratories, with payers, and with scientific institutes. Let's say that the contribution of the ERN to newborn screening, due to the fact that the European Reference Network are multidisciplinary, can be listed in these 8 points. First of all, experience. The European Reference Network are healthcare providers. They interact with medical laboratories and basic science institutes. And so they can add all the expertise needed to make the diagnosis and to have an application to the diagnosis to the patient. They can promote the equity and access to screening because the healthcare providers are throughout Europe. And for this, they can the European Reference Network can create a sort of picture of what is the access of the screening in the different countries and collaborate with different stakeholders to facilitate the application of the screening in different member states. Communication with institutional stakeholders is the one of the most important activities the ERNs are doing. Because, I mean, as I said, the ERNs are a sort of bottleneck of all the different stakeholders, from hospital to payers to companies to any kind of activities that can facilitate the development of newborn screening. Education, testing, clinical service, and project management, the ERN have programs dealing with this. And of course, the newborn screening is something that it is extremely important in the activities of the ERN. And the metabolic one in particular. The interaction with the patients and empowerment of the patient is one of the key objectives of the ERNs. we are patient-centered, and the integration with the family organization is giving also the possibility to answer the unmet needs that we have heard from urologists and that still remains in especially in newborn screening. Technologically speaking, we have also data collection, biobanking methods for data analysis. The progress of science is asking more and more to use and reuse analysis, the data for a proper analysis. In the ERNs, we are developing all the different tools to facilitate this kind of need. To guide the decision pathways, we have all the expertise in the ERN to advise and to create opinion papers and guidelines to understand exactly what the newborn screening need and how the children need to be taken care and how to collaborate with the family for the best care of the child. Availability of therapy, there is no newborn screening without a therapy, and one of the major activity of the European Reference Network is to develop projects for the therapy, for the innovative therapy for rare diseases. Of course, the newborn screening is not a test. It is something that is going around the newborn and the family, and it is a collaboration between the healthcare providers and everybody that is involved in the communication of the disease and the management of the disease itself. So the ERNs are made of hospital where whenever they do newborn screening, this kind of system is working, and it is easy to collaborate and to have the treatment of the family done in the proper way. Of course, the position of the ERNs, in particular the metabolic one of the newborn screening, is that the newborn screening should be regarded as an integrated system. It's not only a test. It is obviously something that requires quite technical skills, but we need also to be very careful about the ethical, the logistical, the educational, and the quality of this test. And the newborn screening is something that need to be discussed about before birth, in order that the couple is aware of what they are doing. And then after birth, whenever there is a diagnosis, to be taken care in order that they can understand exactly what they did in testing, which kind of problems they may have, and then what kind of follow-up and treatment and family assistance they need in order to take care as much as possible. And at the best way, the child with a rare diseases is discovered in the preclinical time. The collaboration is multidisciplinary. You see here all the people that are involved in the newborn screening working group of the metabolic ERN I'm coordinating. And you see that there are all the major actors, patient organization, scientific organization, other ERNs, and all the programs that might be interesting this team. And only by working in a network among healthcare providers, among ERN, and among ERN together with scientific communities, like, for example, the International Society for Newborn Screening, will bring the newborn screening to be conducted in Europe in a very disseminated way and in a very equal way. So in conclusion, what I can say is that the ERNs are for sure one of the major public health programs coordinating the major expert on rare diseases. Since they are ending the first five-year plan and ready to plan the second-year plan, this will be devoted to very practical projects impacting the patient quality of life. And for this, of course, the newborn screening is one of the major ones. The ERNs have a natural structure to contribute to high-level discussion and planning of social programs. And they have the expertise, both at technical and organization level, to really facilitate any kind of visionary project like the newborn screening in Europe in different national health systems. The most important thing is that we are also discussing and producing data and tools in order to collect everything that is generated by such a community program, and to be applied in programs that can optimize and customize the different newborn screening approaches. I hope that this was giving an idea about the impact that the Iran could give to the European community. And now I'm happy to introduce you, Dr. Pizarro, for the next presentation. Thank you very much.